Instead of applying a texture to a surface, we can apply a texture to represent the world itself. In the distance are clouds in all directions. The way this illusion is done is with a skybox. The idea is to put the viewer in the center of a box and put the environment on the walls, floor, and ceiling. Doing this reminds me a bit of The Truman Show, where Truman's world is highly limited and he runs his ship into, well, I don't want to spoil anything if you haven't seen it. The key is that you have to be careful to not let the viewer get too close to the sky so that he doesn't figure out it's just an illusion. If I turn in the wireframe for the cube, the trick is revealed. You can see the walls of the box. Without the wireframe, the illusion is seamless. If the viewer moves around, the center of the box moves with them. In this way, there is no distortion, as the view of the walls never changes. This type of texture is called a cube map. It's made of 6 images that form the cube faces. The viewer is always placed at the center of the cube. For example, here's the frustum for the top of the cube, the plus y face. The cube shape is not required. It's possible to have other geometry, such as a hemispherical dome around the scene. Whatever the shape, our eyes can't see the z-buffer, so can't tell the sky is only, say, 100 meters away. Skyboxes are typically used for star fields or, well, the sky, for times when you're not near the ground. Alternately, you can simply make the surrounding skybox a part of the scene, such as shown here. Real geometry has the advantage that it can receive shadows from the object. The main rule is that you want to make sure that nothing pokes through the walls of the skybox itself. Oh, and one more thing. You definitely want to set the far distance of your camera so that it encompasses the skybox itself. Otherwise, it'll be clipped out.